Hello everyone, welcome to the another video of JCL. In this video, I am going to explain about the JCL structure. Especially, I will discuss about the column position. We know that JCL statements are structured in fixed format lines where each column has a specific meaning. It is essential to understand this position as they determine how the system interprets and processes your JCL code. So let's go to the mainframe screen and explore all these things. This is the mainframe. I am using Hercules mainframe, so there will be a little bit different in the interface if I am comparing to Hercules and the IBM ZOS operating system of mainframe, but all the function and the keyword will be same. So giving here command 3.4 for the data set and Hercules, that is the prefix, and here I have already allocated PS and PDS file. So just open any PS file or PDS to understand those things. So here you can see here is no any column. For see the column, give here command calls C-O-L-S and give enter. So these are the columns. So we start from one. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Plus indicates 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 indicates 10. So likewise, it will be 15, 20, 25, 30, 60, 65, 70, 71, 72. So first we start from the column 1 and 2. Column 1 and 2 is used as a identifier. Identifier means I will have to code here double forward slice. It indicates that after the double forward slice, we can write any the statement of the JCL. So when we will submit this program for the execution, the system will identify, okay, these are the code we need to execute. But if we put a strix or a star after the double forward slice in the third column, that will be comment line. So if you want to comment any line, I am giving here another line, double forward slice and the strix, and write any comment like this is a JCL program to allocate a PS file, and save, enter. So you can see the color is different from the another line, and this is the comment line. So when we will submit this program for the execution, this line will be ignored because this is the comment line, and in the third column there are a star or a strix. So first 1, 2 as identifier, and after the 3 to 10, 3 to 10 is used as the name field. In the name field, we code the job name and the program name or the data definition name. We can write between 3 to 10. And after this, 12 to 15 is used as operation field. In the operation field, there will be job statements, exec statement, DD statement. We will see all these statements later in the next video. For now, we are going to only focus on the column. So just remember 12 to 15 is used for the operation field. And after that, 17, like 16, this one is 17, 17 to 71. This column is used for the operand field. In the operands field, there are many parameters like positional parameter, keyboard parameters. We can code between these columns 17 to 71. Like you can see, notifies the also a statement of the JCL, and the message level, it is also a statement of the JCL. And after this 71, this one is the 71 and this one is the 72. 72 is used as a continuation. Continuation means like if you are coding something in first line, so just class equal to a and something like that, if you want to add another parameter and we reach the limit of this line, in 71. So using continuation, we can write those statements in the next line. So when we will submit this program for the execution, the system will identify, okay, this is the continuation, and the next statement or the parameters are coded in the another line. So we won't get any error. And after the 72, we need to scroll right, so press F11, 71, 72, and after the 73 to 80, this is the sequential number. We don't need to do anything with this number. This is used by the system only. So just remember, we have total 80 column in JCL to code, but we used only 72 for coding, and the remaining 73 to 80 are used by the system. So all these are the column. For scroll left, press F10 and back. So if you want to hide this column, give command pulse again and see. This is the end of the video. In the next video, we will discuss about the job and all these parameters like positional parameters and the keyword parameter. If you like the video, do subscribe, and if you want to ask anything, you have any doubts, you can comment below, or my all social handle is mentioned in the description of this video. You can text anywhere. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.